Hi, good evening, everyone. Welcome to Encounter Hall. Hey, Jim.
Hi, Grace. How are you tonight?
Good. Good to see you.
It's good to be here. Yeah. Thank you.
Well, let's begin, as we do, with Choose to Hope.
Sounds good to me.
Service of contemplation. And just as a reminder, contemplation is a process of awareness, of deep reflection, inward soul's vision, and that rest in God's tranquility and peace. So we can all begin with one deep inhale together and exhale. So we invite you to relax and sit comfortably, breathe deeply, open your heart, look inward, and center on that love of God. And as we do that, we will continue with You Are Mine. To discover and remember more of You within us. Help us to remember Your great gift of peace. Bless us in this time and fill us with Your love. Amen. Thank you. scripture comes from John 14, 23 through 29. And in our story today, Jesus is preparing his disciples for when once he's gone, and he's telling them about the Holy Spirit.
Oh, cool.
So, Jim, would you mind reading for us today?
I wouldn't mind at all. Thanks for asking, Grace. Jesus answered him, "Those who love me will keep my word, and my Father will love them. And we will come to them and make our home with them. Whoever does not love me does not keep my words. And the word that you hear is not mine, but it is from the Father who sent me. I have said these things to you while I am still with you. But the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, that is, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything and remind you of all that I have said to you. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not let them be afraid. You heard me say to you, I am going away, and I am coming to you. If you loved me, you would rejoice that I am going to the Father, because the Father is greater than I. And now I have told you this before it occurs, so that when it does occur, you may believe."
Thank you, Jim.
Sure.
So in our first week of contemplation, we learned how we could recognize our true shepherd by their voice of unconditional love. And then last week we heard that we ourselves are recognized by disciples of Jesus by the love that we share in the world. And this week we learn that this love overflows because God abides within us. And we have been given the Holy Spirit to give us peace and encourage us on our journey. So in our story from John today, Jesus knows that he will soon be dying and that this big change will soon be happening. And he wants to share a couple things to give his disciples a sense of peace. For the disciples, Jesus dying is like really bad news. So Jesus is preparing them for his departure by sharing these things. First, Jesus says that God will gift us, them, the Spirit of truth, and that we will know the Spirit because it abides within us. Jesus wants his disciples to know that they won't be orphaned when he dies, and although they soon won't see Jesus physically, they will still commune with God and God with them through the Spirit. Can you imagine what might have been going through the disciples' heads? Like, wait, what, you're leaving? And also, you're still here? You see, while Jesus walked the earth, his ministry was contained to one place and one person, himself. But upon his death, his followers are given the Spirit and moved from students and apprentices to full and realized beings spreading God's love. The disciples and us now are the hands and feet of God's love in the world. And this happens just not to the first disciples, the ones sitting with Jesus that day, but all who would come later. Those who have never witnessed historical Jesus, like us. And to help us along in our journey and give us peace, we are also gifted the Holy Spirit. And Jesus describes the Holy Spirit as a spirit who guides, reminds, and abides. So first let's take a little peek to guide and remind. In the Bible, the role of the Holy Spirit varies, but in our text from John today, the meaning and function of the Spirit is one who comes to walk alongside followers and show them the way of truth. Kind of like we might walk with a child and show them how to stay safe on the sidewalks. A word that also comes to mind for me is accompaniment. I'm a singer and I love to share my vocal selections, but often I need the accompaniment of the piano or a director to keep me on key, build the musicality, and to be the foundation of the performance. The Spirit is this sort of guide, this interwoven helper, pointing and showing the way. The Spirit will also teach us everything and remind us of all that Jesus has said to us, just as the piano's melody might remind me to help me find the right notes. But for Jesus, this is not just about music. The Holy Spirit is here to remind and guide us to remember the new commandment that he gave us just verses before, the commandment which we discovered last week. To love one another as we have been loved. The Holy Spirit is here to guide and remind us of this. Now let's think for a moment about abide. Jesus said, "Those who love me will keep my word, and my God will love them, and we will come to them and make our home in them. And this Greek word for make our home also kind of means abide or to dwell. So God is abiding within us. Now, usually when someone announces they're coming to stay with me, I begin to prepare. When I have guests scheduled to come over, I clean my apartment and I wash new sheets and I clear the cobwebs out of the nooks and crannies that I might ignore most of the time. I make sure the trash is out and the pillows are fluffed. When I'm expecting a visitor, I want to be sure the place is ready for them. I create space for them to fill, for them to dwell. So one question we may ask ourselves is, have we created a space for God to dwell? Have we prepared to host someone who is taking up residence in our lives? Do we need to create a space for God to abide within us? Well, sure, it could be helpful to feel at peace and use tools like prayer, worship, contemplation, meditation, fellowship, and community to prime and prepare our vessels for God. And of course, we would be better equipped to share love into the world when that space for God's love is already great within us. But I also have a sneaking suspicion that God's abiding doesn't have any preparation requirements. When I lived in Colorado, I had a best friend, Nellie. We were teachers together and lived near one another, and we would often carpool to work together. We're besties, you might call it. When Mel was about to come over, I didn't hurry to tidy or clear out cobwebs or fluff pillows and ensure everything was just so, because Mel is a soul friend. I knew it wouldn't matter if my place was its normal cluttered self. Because Mel was not a visitor. Like I said, she was a soul friend deep in my heart. In this way, God is also not a visitor. God is going to come over and abide with us no matter what. We can show that we're welcoming a place for God by keeping the word and the commandment to love one another, and we can even pick up a little and make things fresh if we like, but God doesn't expect that. God's already moved in to our clutter or our clean, our magic or our mess, because God's not a visitor. And I might stretch to consider that we are not a visitor to God either. As Lutherans, we're familiar with the Trinity, God the Father, Jesus the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And in our text today from John, John essentially offers another perspective, what Jamie Clark Solis called the quadrinity. In John, Jesus says that the intimate relationship between him, God, and the Spirit also includes believers. The believer isn't just on the side waving at the nice-looking Trinity of God, but rather the believer is kind of within, among, a part of it. In our text today, John repeats that God abides in us, that there is oneness, that we don't imitate Jesus, but we participate in him fully. If God and Christ in God have made their home within us, then we are truly intimately connected with God, and God and Christ are available exactly now, and their love is made known within us and through us in this moment. So Jesus in our text today shared these two big things, that God abides within us and that the Holy Spirit is given to us as a guide. And these things are shared to the disciples to give them a sense of peace. In fact, it is right before Jesus and the disciples are about to continue on their journey that Jesus leaves them with this one note about peace, because he wants them to be assured. We all experience times of worry, conflict, things other than peace. When someone leaves our home, our lives can feel emptiness or sorrow, and especially when someone leaves the earthly plane, we can feel scared, and many people live with a fear around death. But Jesus wanted to calm all these worries and fears. Jesus says, "Don't be afraid, because I am going to God that is greater than I." Because Jesus and the Holy Spirit abide within God. And we abide within God just as God abides within us. Because we are made of God and God created us, we can never be away from the love of God. The love of God is woven into being in all forms. In fact, I also think that God is the material that is woven. But thinking about all these things in such a big way can't really be put into words, and it can be really difficult to wrap our minds around. So I just taught a fun contemplation activity where you pick up an object and you think back to where it's from and forward to where it's going. And this exercise can be a really helpful metaphor for the love of God and the forms through which it is expressed. So I thought we could give it a try. So here we have a stapler. Jim, do you see the stapler here?
I do, and up there.
Yeah, and up there.
Yeah.
So, Jim, would you mind helping me out in this activity today?
I'll do my best, Grace.
Okay. I just have a few questions for you.
Okay.
Okay. So here's a stapler. So yes. Where do you think this was about 10 minutes ago?
I'm guessing it was back in your office.
Yeah, it was in my office. Okay. How about like 10 years ago?
10 years ago, it was in some department store ready to be sold.
Yeah, I would guess so. Probably maybe Office Max.
Sure.
Sitting on the shelf. What about like 100 years ago?
I don't think it had been thought of.
Yeah, it probably wasn't created yet. So it was kind of like in the ground as oil or metal, probably.
Sure.
Okay. And what about like 10 million years ago?
Oh my gosh. I have no idea.
Well, I would say that oil was probably like leaves or like microplankton swimming around in the sea.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. So 10 million years ago, this stapler was swimming around in the sea or the leaves on trees. Okay. Yeah. Made its journey to us here. So now let's look into the future. Where will the stapler be in 10 minutes, do you think?
Back on your desk.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And how about like in 10 years?
Oh, still on your desk.
Hopefully, yeah. We don't like to throw away things that quickly.
No.
How about maybe 100 years?
Still on your desk?
Maybe.
Yeah.
Let's say we threw it out. Where would it be?
Oh, then it'd be in the garbage.
Yeah, it'd probably be decomposing in the dump.
Landfill.
Yeah. And so then if we look 10,000 years into the future, where might the stapler be?
About where it started 10,000 years ago.
Yeah, it might be back to being a tree or something like that.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, there's the tale of the stapler.
Well, that's interesting.
So the stapler never really ends. It may change shape or form or phase, but it never ceases to exist. And in this way, but even bigger, God's love never ends. God's love is expressed through the Creator, and then the Savior, and then the Spirit among us, and through us, and all these things at once. And we, in our own forms, are a piece and a part and extension of that love of God. In this human body and in this time, we have the Spirit to guide and support us, and we have God's abiding love within us, expressed through us. And even when we pass on from this life, we too will return to the fullness of God, because God's not a visitor. God is with us now and always. There is no separation and no ceasing to be. God will always abide in us and we in God. And Jesus wanted us to know this. Jesus wanted us to be at peace. So to end the message today, I wanted to share a poem from Julian of Norwich. And she was born in 1342. And she was a mystic who wrote in seclusion. And she wrote Revelations on Divine Love. And she said, God is all that is good, and God made all that is made, and God loves every part of it. If you love all people because of God's love, then you will love each created thing because you love the Creator. For God is in every person, and every person is in God. If you love in this way, you love all. So now, taking all that into consideration and our lesson from the stapler, let's take a deep breath together and exhale. And now, do our questions of contemplation. So the first one, can I understand how God abides within me? And our second question, can I be God's hands and feet of love in the world? And our third question, can I anchor myself now in peace, in the knowledge of the unending love of God? So God of love, thank you for your gift of peace and the Holy Spirit. Help us to anchor our hearts in this peace as we are the hands and feet of love in the world. Amen.
And where there's not true faith in
Everybody have a wonderful week. See you next week.